You're at 23400 to 23478 W9 Mile Road, Southfield, Michigan.
I'm not going to go at it as fast as somebody who only has 3 or 4 degrees and they are known to be somewhat tight. That's just their persona. So for somebody who's really loose jointed, like the question asked, I'd probably say get maybe half of it, something like that. If they had 10 or 15 degrees, I'd probably get 5 to 7 degrees. Relatively quickly. I'm not going to try to crank on their knee, but I want the patient to comfortably get it and feel comfortable getting it at home. And then the rest of it usually comes with just functional activity because they have that underlying tissue laxity. There are some studies out there that show people who have hypermobile tissue have more elastin and collagen in their makeup. So they are going to get the motion back easier than somebody who doesn't. We don't know that we're going to biopsy everybody's legs or biopsy everybody's tissue, but I think you know pretty quickly by some kind of convenience score or something like that and just getting information that will help to guide how quickly you want to progress somebody. But for somebody to answer the question, so symmetry is a point. Numerous studies have shown that it's a point in functional outcomes and won't put stress on the ligament. And so that's my goal, is pretty quickly try to get most of the motion back, but let the rest of the back.
And going historically through that, I think this speaks to both our experience, but I think this is the general experience too. At first, I agree, we were definitely like, let's get it all back, let's get hyperextension back right away. Then I think we evolved a little bit like, let's try to keep it neutral. A lot of people said, let's keep it neutral, it's going to put too much stress. And then we evolved to kind of like, be a little bit more individualized, but tend to lean on restoring, but not forcing maybe. So let's go through a couple of specifics and then, anyone jump in based on opinion. If somebody on the contralateral leg has 0 to 5 degrees hyperextension, how much do you get back and how fast? Glenn, you want to start? And then if anybody disagrees or agrees.
So they have 5 degrees hyperextension, that makes sense.
0 to 5 degrees, and somebody's in that zone on the contralateral side, are you getting it all back and how fast?
I'm going to probably get them to at least 0, at least, we measure, I can have 3 to 5 degrees of error, but I'm going to get it back somewhat quickly, 0 to 2, which I want to see a little hyperextension when they come in. I'm not going to try to get them to 5 right away, but I want to see a little hyperextension, those first couple weeks, and we keep it. Because if we don't keep it, if they start coming in and they start lacking extension, you start worrying about a cyclops lesion.
So I was going to say, so if they have 5 degrees on the other side, you get them to 2 forever, or do you ever get them to 5?
No, I'm going to get them to 5 eventually, but I'm going to monitor it every time somebody comes in to see me after an ACL. I don't care if they're 9 months out of surgery. That's the first thing I look on at somebody is their extension. I want to measure their extension. So to them, I'm not going to get it immediately, but I'm going to get them to 5 degrees eventually. How quickly that comes back, I don't know. We'll see. We'll monitor it. If they are kind of hovering at 2 and they're stuck there at 8 months out of surgery, well, hopefully I didn't mess that up and I should be more aggressive. But I think they're eventually going to get them to 5 degrees by the time that they are doing functional activities and feeling good.
Anybody else?
That's too beautiful. I don't want to mess it up.
As heck. I feel like somebody in the 0 to 5 range, I'd be a little bit more prone to get them to 5 sooner, to be honest. I think what we're trying to do is we're trying to chump people in terms of their hyperlaxed.
Correct. That might be something. Right. I would get them. So instead of getting...
I feel like you would too.
Maybe I can say, well, that person has 10 to 15 degrees of hyperextension. I'm not going to push on that. I'm going to let that come naturally because that's going to come. That person was probably a little tighter and only has that 0 to 5 somewhere in that range. I'm going to get 2-ish, 3-ish, something like that, and then just let the rest kind of hopefully come. But I'm probably going to be a little bit more aggressive. Probably going to be able to go on low load, long duration stretching with them because I know that they are just not that tissue laxed person.
If they're 2 months out and they're 2 degrees versus 5 degrees, I know that doesn't sound like a lot. I'm doing low load. I'm working on that. I'm concerned about that. So yeah. I feel like the 0 to 5, I'd be a little bit more prone to get them closer to 5 sooner than later. Like not week one, but probably within the first month. Now somebody with 15, 20 degrees on the other side.
Yeah,
we do. How does that change the equation?
There's big arguments out there, so I'm always, as you guys know, hovering in social media world, and there's some docs
the
are like
blogosphere.
The blogosphere on the internet. And I have conversations on Twitter and stuff like that with docs who are like, no, do not. And if they have 10 or 15 degrees of hyperextension, you keep them at 0. I don't want them to tear their ACL. Yeah. I mean 0 or barely get hyperextension.
What percentage of that difference though? You think that's a 20% difference?
Can you imagine being that person who has a 15-20 degree difference in their amount of motion in their knee compared to the other side, and how differently that feels? But the doctor's concerned structurally, right? The doctor's concerned with re-tearing that ligament. We're concerned with function. It comes down to this oftentimes, especially with rotator cuff repairs, right? We're concerned with function. Can the person go and do their life? The doctor's concerned with re-tearing that rotator cuff. Same thing with this ACL thing. For me, if somebody has 15 degrees, I'm going to get them 7 degrees or so, 7 or 8 degrees, about half. And then...
Not 9. And 9 would be
not
10, bad.
Not 9.
No, that ligament out. 9.
roughly half. And
yeah, no, I like that.
Usually the rest will come back. I'll prop them up. I'm not going to put a 10-pound ankle weight on their knee. You know, I don't need to do that, but I'm going to prop them up and just let gravity kind of push their knee straight, and I'm going to monitor them. I'm going to maybe give them a little overpressure. If they're feeling pain in the front of their knee when I start doing overpressure or if I start assessing them, that's usually more indicative of a Cyclops lesion than if they feel pressure in the back of their knee. That's going to be more indicative of capsule and or hamstring. So that's another nice little test that you can do, is that overpressure test. If you start seeing somebody losing motion, or they're kind of plateauing or getting irritable in the anterior knee, look for the Cyclops lesion, because it's in 5 to 10% of cases typically, but I think it's underdiagnosed, and it's the reason why people don't get their motion back. There's a lot of what I see in my practice, because of a blog post and video that I did, and people are finding me all over the place because of missing Cyclops lesions, and just assuming getting zero is good enough.
So think about it. If you have 15 degrees of hyperextension, you only get to 0 to 5, which a lot of people say. That person is not getting to their terminal knee. They're not getting their full screw home mechanism. They probably have their quadriceps isometrically engaged all freaking day. You know, they're all just like walking around. I can't wait to see that transcribed below all freaking day, too, by the way. So can I say, don't transcribe those last two sentences, fourth sentence, now three sentences? I don't know what to do anyway. But, like, think about it. Like, if you're used to having hyperextension, you don't, you feel like that thing is bent 90 degrees. Right? So, and it's going to be a functional thing. We tend to see people with hyperextension that don't get their extension back have a really hard time getting their quad back, and they're going to have a ton of problems down the road with that, right? So it's something to keep in mind. So, you know, I guess just to summarize, I guess I would say again, like, that 0 to 5 range, I feel like where you could argue they're not, like, super lats, would probably be, that's the person that's coming in, where maybe we're putting, like a little ankle weight over their distal thigh to kind of give some overpressure into extension, let them...